What is a sequential cohort design? This is a developmental study designed to follow multiple samples of different age groups, with testing of those age groups over specified intervals of time. This design begins with an initial baseline testing of separate samples of differing age groups. As such, age is treated as a between subjects factor, also known as a cross-sectional design. As the initial groups age over time, they are tested multiple times in varying stages of development. Increasing age within each sample is thus seen as a within subjects factor, as in a longitudinal design. Our study, which is based on the sequential cohort design, is a study of altruism in adolescence through young adulthood, ages 12 to 24 years. Altruism is the belief or practice of concern over the welfare of others. It is widely believed to be one of the basic characteristics of resiliency, which is seen as a successful pro-social behavioral trait in combating adversity. We pulled our sample through a cluster sampling. We identified all of the public middle and high schools in the state of Texas, and then randomly selected 10 middle schools and 10 high schools to sample from. We are selecting subjects based on their age. For sample one, we have 12-year-olds. For sample two, we begin with 15-year-olds. And for sample three, we begin with 18-year-olds. This will be year one and a baseline test. We test again at year three. Sample one has now turned 15. Sample two is now age 18. And sample three is now age 21. Finally, we test lastly at year six. Sample one is now age 18. Sample 2 is now age 21, and sample 3 is now aged 24. This is a quasi-experiment design, as age is a subject variable and cannot be manipulated. It's also a between and within subjects design. There are three different samples, which are between subjects, that are tested as they age at 3-year intervals, which is considered within subjects, over a period of 6 years. The variables. Our dependent variable, which is interval, is the level of altruism on a variation of the Rushton, Christian, and Fecken self-report altruism scale, modified for adolescents. It's a self-report scale that focuses on 14 specific behaviors, with each item being scored from 0 to 4. It's survey research, closed-ended response scale, so the data is quantitative. It consists of questions such as, I would voluntarily look after a neighbor's pet or children without being paid, or I would help a classmate who I did not know well with a homework assignment when my knowledge was greater than his or hers. Our independent variables, which are broken down in two groups, and they're nominal, the first one being a between subjects group, consisting of our three age group levels, baseline at 12, 15, and 18-year-olds. Our second independent variable, within subjects grouping, each sample is measured 3 times over various levels. They're measured every 3 years, starting with year 1, year 3, and then finally at year 6. We will be using a mixed ANOVA as our statistic to analyze the data, and there is no true manipulated independent variable. Once again, age is a subject variable used in this design. Various threats to validity include testing effects. They remain an issue as participants are tested multiple times over a 6-year period. We could combat this with the creation of a different, equally weighted version of the altruism questionnaire. Attrition is also a common problem with developmental studies for various reasons. Participants may drop out, they may move away, leaving a sample pool that might bias the end result. Maturation, or natural changes that occur to our participants over time, could also possibly bias the outcome of the study due to vast developmental changes that are occurring during an adolescent's growth. As we test our participants over a period of 6 years, history effects that are unforeseen, such as natural disasters, armed conflicts, etc., and not a part of the experiment, could affect the way that participants self-report, thus skewing data collected and reducing internal validity. Generation cohort effects. One generation of ages have different experiences than the other. could also rise as a problem. As we are testing three different samples as they age over 6 years, each age group will experience adolescence and young adulthood uniquely. Finally, social desirability bias, or the tendency to answer or act in the most favorable way viewed by others, is a large concern with self-reported data. We plan on counterbalancing this bias by using a self-report altruism scale that's been scientifically validated and utilized in multiple research experiments. There are also general threats to reliability that have been reduced through the following measures. There are the inclusion of two researchers conducting this study. The testing of participants are being tested in the same environment each time. And once again, the use of a scientifically validated questionnaire created specifically to measure the characteristics of altruism in a younger population.